time this one's really thick.
Collects, yeah. Hit that Macari, sell what he gets, yeah. He do unboxings and giveaways, yeah. Let's get to watching what he gets today, yeah. Castell collects, Castell collects, yeah. Castell collects, Castell collects, yeah. He do unboxings and giveaways, yeah. Let's get to watching what he gets today, yeah. Castell collects.
You know, look, at the end of the day, I'm a buyer. That's what I do. I buy. And if you saw a video a couple days ago about ups and downs, that's what it's all about, ups and downs. But what I've been doing is I've been posting a lot of the toy groups telling people if they want to sell me a mystery box, they have prices of $50, $75, $200. I'm going to do it once a week for a couple months and see how it pans out. So far, it hasn't panned out very well. But two of the people that I have purchased mystery boxes from in the past sent me mystery boxes, and I paid $100 for one and $75 for the other. And there's a couple boxes that I don't really know what they are, but I know they were like older mystery boxes that just didn't come in, and they came in now, which is really weird. So let's get into it. Let's see what we got. And also, I did a little box of pickups. So I'm gonna explain to you guys what those pickups are and why I did them and why they were a good price. So let's get into this unboxing and show you what we got. All right, so our first box here is, it says my name on it. I don't know. Why do I use a screwdriver? I couldn't quite freaking tell you, but it is what I have, so we're just gonna wing it there, aren't we? What is this? What? This came already? Okay, this is an awesome pickup right here. So this was something that I bought on the whim because I didn't even know it was an actual figure. It is a Super 7 piece. It is going to go towards my line that you guys know, because I have a couple of Super 7s down here for the Power Rangers, but this is the other line that I collect, and I bragged that 100 times. I am going to do a review video of them. Honestly, I'm not opening any of them, but this one I didn't even know existed. So let me show you guys what this is, because it looks really freaking cool, and I hope it doesn't have a... Yeah, there it is. So this is, now there's Burning Godzilla, and then there's Godzilla 1200 degrees. So this is the Godzilla 1200 degrees figure. I don't even know where this came from. It just popped up in my email, and they said, new Godzilla figure, 1200 degrees, buy now. So I bought it now. But what's weird is this is a lot more expensive than the regular Super 7 line. It's normally like $60 to, I guess, $80. This one was $104 with shipping and handling, which is like really weird because I've never paid that much for it. The box is in good condition. Super 7 stopped putting the sleeves over them, which does kind of suck, but it shows you it's the Ultimates. You know I got a couple of these already the last couple weeks, so I'm very excited about those, but I thought this piece was so awesome. And honestly, look how cool it is, the 1200 degree Godzilla. It looks crazy. This is a, it's not my favorite Godzilla, because my favorite Godzilla is it 84, I think it is? 84 is my favorite Godzilla. But yeah, I mean, very interesting. Look at this, very, yeah. Awesome piece. Happy to have it in the collection. Let's keep going. Oh, but before we keep going, I want to show you guys this. So that Godzilla came in a shipper box. Now, just like statues, guys, you always got to keep the cardboard. So no matter what, with every one I've gotten, especially because these newer Super 7s don't have the sleeve that goes over them, keep your shipper boxes. I feel like these are really important to own. So I don't know why, but just keep them. Very important. All right. So we got another box right here. It is from Grand Island, Nebraska. So this is a $75 mystery box. It's from KO Toys. It's only two boxes, so you know that's nerve-wracking. Transformers Super 7 line. Bludgeon. That's weird. Oh, wow. This is awesome. Look at this. So it's only two pieces. I think it's a $75 on my little manuscript. Wow. This is freaking cool. Bludgeon, the Decepticon from Transformers. Very, very cool. I'm gonna look this up, hold on. All right, so I just looked up Bludgeon, and it looks like this particular piece is anywhere between $25 and $35. So this is definitely 75 bucks. I also looked up on that. I'm hoping that they did me right, because there's only two boxes and they look like two Super 7 pieces. So let's just call $30 to be safe. And let's hope to God the next one is more. So I'm like, I think this is a bad idea, like trying to do this mystery box this way. It was better doing it with people that I knew instead of random people. Because I think the people that I'm letting do it random, they're giving me the equal value. And like no one's really giving me anything cool. And this is the second week doing it. I'm only going to do it one more week after this, and I'm not doing it all. That's just the bottom line. I don't mind losing sometimes, but I'm not going to lose every time. And so far, I've pretty much lost. And this one's probably going to be a break even, and that's certainly not the goal of this. It's tracks. Oh, love tracks. Let's see what this looks like. Oh, this is pretty cool from the side. Oh, this is clean. Very cool. Very cool tracks action figure. I'm going to look it up right now and see what this thing goes for. Yet again, I mean, this is another piece. It says it goes for $30 to $40. It sold on eBay for $40 last, so that was probably it. So it's a break-even. It's really just, I don't even know why I'm even allowing this. It's a break-even box. It is what it is. All right, this next box right here, looking at the tracking number it was, it's about a $100 box. It's a lot of peanuts in here, so let's just... I'm going to do it with you guys, and we're going to hope that there's stuff in here. Okay, there is one piece so far. Whoa. Okay, off the bat, we've got a heater. Micro Machines, Titanus, and the King Sphinx. These sell for anywhere between $20 and $30. This one's a little bit beat up, so probably about 20 is probably the right number for it. So we got that. Bigger box, but there's another one here. I'm like trying not to mess up everything, but you know, it's a little, it's these dang peanuts. Oh, he knew I was a Broncos fan, so he hooked me up with a Jay Cutler Broncos, the worst figure ever. Here, oh, nice, the Megazord and Squat Power Rangers Micro Machines. So, again, the card is a little messed up. These do go for $20 to $30 each. These are the Zord packs, so these are very important. The next one I'm missing would be the Dragon Zord. But again, $20, $30, call them $20 each. They're a little bit beat up on the card, you know. But all in all, the bubbles are good. They look, you know, relative. I mean, again, just dusty cards. So call $40 here. We're $50. So $50, we are on the right track. Yeah, again, they knew I was a Broncos fan, so they hooked me up with the headliners, John Elway. I don't know, $5 maybe for something like this. Oh, what is this? Wait. Oh, the LeBron James and Bugs Bunny Space Jam. So this is a cool piece. I've seen him sell for about $20. Really nothing to get excited about, but there is something that is definitely putting me over the top. Okay, so this sells for between $15 to $20. So we're at $40, $50, $55, another $15. We're at $70, but I can see what this last piece is, and this is an over the... Oh, yeah, this is sick. This is a mint on card, Chip Hazard Battle Damage. This was a good mystery box, guys. This is the mystery boxes we want. These are the hits that we want. So when I send out my mystery list to people, I say, hey, listen, these are the items that I personally collect. These are my likes. But I'm always looking to resell. So Small Soldiers, Broncos, Power Rangers are all on my list of my favorites, along with Marvel, a couple other things I wrote. I don't remember what it was on the list right now. But yeah, so this is like Voltron is it? Anyway, Dragon Ball Z, yeah. But anyway, but the Small Soldiers is on it. I'm not selling this. This piece right here, so we're at $70 right here. This piece right here, I've seen sell from anywhere $50 to $75. And this thing is like a razor blade. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful piece. I'm putting this with my rest of my collection. I love it. This is awesome. So this was a hit. So, okay, guess what? We're going to do more mystery boxes because I paid $100 for this box. And we definitely are over it. So again, we're about $75 for everything you see here. Did I say $75? So we went low. We went $40, $50. We went 15 on this, 65 plus 70, and 75 on this. We're at 145 in value for this box. And you may say, well, how do you know that? Because I do this every freaking day. But let's keep going because we got more to do. All right, so this is another $100 box. It's a big box. I know I haven't been doing a lot of statues of you guys, but there's literally just nothing coming in. I mean, it has been nothing shy of a nightmare to get pieces in. $100 box. Please don't do me wrong. A lot of wrapping. The heck? Oh my God. This has got to be like something wrong with this. There's no way this is real. This is real life. They just sent me a Nintendo Wii. In the box. Hold on. This has got to be... There's got to be something wrong. All right. So this is very cool. It is a... original Nintendo Wii. These sell for about $100. So this is a break even. But this is a used Wii, which is kind of gross. I don't really like used video games. Although I'm excited about it, I'm really not happy about this. We're going to get back to you guys on this one. I think it's missing the video game also, which I think I could buy and make it worth $100. But a cool surprise. I'll probably keep it in the vault. But... it's used, and I don't ask for used things, so I'm going to make a phone call on this one. We'll be right back. All right, guys, we got one more mystery box from the best mystery boxer. This guy has hooked me up numerous times, my boy Will. Now, guys, every time Will has done a mystery box for me, I have... okay, let's not say every time, but a lot of the times that Will's done mystery boxes with me, you guys have seen he's given me some really, really, really cool things, including the Power Ranger Micro Machine line. This is another $100 box. I'm really upset about that Wii, man. That Wii was cool, but it's used. It's kind of danky looking in the inside. Ugh. Yo! Oh my God. Bro. Tell me this is brand new. Yo, this is a brand... that definitely doesn't work. Yo, let me explain to you. The whole box is packed with them. What? Unopened. I'm not even messing with you guys right now. It's unopened. Unopened. Red Ranger, Pink Ranger, White Ranger. Oh my God. And there's more. Guys, Blue Ranger, brand new. Oh my God. Oh my God! Yo, this is crazy. This is the original Power Ranger gloves. 1994, okay. Back in 1994, Power Rangers are one of the biggest things that ever happened. There's definitely like crybaby moms saying that they're too violent and, you know, their kids can't watch it, whatever. But they made these awesome sets of gloves and you would like cling them together and stuff and they would make the sounds. I just can't speak right now. This is crazy. Okay, so I do see a little flaw with these. Okay, there is a flaw. Not a flaw, but there's a little bit of a problem, I should say, okay? So because they're so old, they are yellowing out a little bit. So the White Ranger's gold is starting to rub away. This is where the button is, where the power pack is, which means the batteries are probably leaking in there. But this, you see the yellowing in between the fingers, this is age. These are so old. This is a hit, okay? This is what the mystery boxes are all about. This right here, I would say I've seen a set of these with the yellow sell for about $200 to $300. But not with the White Ranger. So I'm thinking just this set of five right here without the Yellow Ranger is still worth $350 is probably a safe number because I've seen the White Ranger gloves alone go for $120. These I've seen go for $70. So if we're just doing the high numbers, we're at $190 just alone right here. Call each other $140. $40, $40, $40. That's another $120. So... yeah, we're about $3 to $350. This is mental. I need help. All right, guys. So we obviously had some crazy hits today. And I got to tell you, it started off rocky. You know, we definitely broke even on the first one, without a doubt. But the other two were definitely home runs, and they make me want to continue doing mystery boxes. I will say probably everything you saw, with the exception of Major Chip Hazard, I'm probably going to put on Mercari to sell. Not because I want to, but only because I really don't necessarily need it. But yeah, I probably will sell majority of that stuff. However, I do want to talk to you guys about something really crazy. And it's this next thing I have. It's a box of stuff. Now, this box of stuff is very simple. Nothing crazy, but it's a point, because a lot of people that ask me about collecting and what they should buy, I'm going to show you how you start at a budgeted way. So the way this works is this. When you buy certain memberships to certain things, like, for instance, Best Buy. Best Buy is a total tech membership program. So here's the first purchase that I did, and we're going to do a special tribute video for this. So that's going to take some time, so we'll talk about that later. The first purchase I did at Best Buy was, this is for my personal reasons. I'm actually doing a special video for my Uncle Michael, who passed away about a year ago. Now, the day goes by, I don't think about him, but he had a Corvette just like this. This is probably one of the coolest Corvettes I've ever seen in person. So when they made the Lego set, I knew I wanted to buy one, but it goes for $149. Now, if you have the Best Buy Total Tech membership, it was actually on sale and they price matched. So check this out. So it went on sale at Target for $119. So I bought it at Best Buy because it was just there. They matched it for $119. Then Best Buy now has a $30 off the original price. So not only do I get it for the $119, I get it minus another $30, which means that I'm only going to pay about $85 for it. Plus I had rewards, so it was really a $30 I paid for it. But again, $150 piece, and with the total tech and the price matching, it was $119. After another $30 in the price match, it came down to $90. So yeah, home run. And we're gonna do a special build video dedicated to my Uncle Michael. So we'll see this in the next videos to come. So when I tell you guys about collecting things, Lego is a huge thing to collect. Don't get me wrong. I've been buying big Lego pieces that are really expensive to say. A lot of the Star Wars ones, the Hulkbuster I purchased, but they're all going in the vault and they're never going to leave. I'm just going to leave them there. But I'm also buying smaller pieces, smaller Star Wars ones that seem to get a lot of traction with specific figures in them. Like I just bought the Dark Millennium Falcon, which was interesting in itself, but I did purchase that. So those are different things that I buy because I just see futures in them. Don't follow me on that. I'm just doing it because I see futures in that stuff. We've got pocketbooks. So these awesome little Dragon Ball Z backpacks. They were originally... Oh, okay. So you can't see it, but behind this it says $64.99. But it was reduced in price for a very long time to $46. Now, if you purchase a pro member at GameStop, I think it's $30 a year or $50 a year, something to that nature. So they do pro days. Now, pro days are very, very, very important for guys like me who want to do a lot of reselling. So if you're a member, automatically you get things for a discounted price. Now, hypothetically speaking, if you had seen that sticker, it said $46, but if you're a pro member, it's $42. So I'm going to save $2 right there. No big deal. So they do these things called pro days. So if you're a pro, this is where it matters most. Because in a pro day, you buy two, you get one free. But that's only the tip of the iceberg. We're going to get to that in a second. But the other cool thing about GameStop is when you buy a clearance item sometimes, it's sometimes buy one, get two free. Buy one, get three free. Buy one, get six free. They do a lot of really crazy promotions. In this case, I did the buy one, got one free, and they're both $40 to $50 each. But wait, there's more. I then got for free the Spider-Man No Way Home gauntlet. So I got all three pieces. Clearance is at $46, right? $49 here. So I had to buy the most expensive one, which is $49, $3 difference. And I got these bags free. So I got $80 in merch for free and $50 right here, which is selling for $50 or $70, whichever one comes first. I didn't buy it because I wanted it. I bought it because there's money to be made in everything here. But again, the proof is in the pudding. These bags are $64.99. They were on clearance for $46. This started at $100 and I got on clear for half off. So even if I sell this thing for $70, I'm in the money. It doesn't matter. I'm in the money. So these are things that I do that I want to show you guys that you could do to make money whenever you're starting your collection or if you're trying to buy, sell, and trade. So now the other thing I was talking about to you guys about GameStop, when you're a pro member, the pro member, you get these special perks like buy two, get one free for probably 80% of the things in the store. Now, I've already opened up most of them because I'm a psychopath, but I love these blind bags. I'm obsessed with these blind bags. These blind bags are my favorite things to buy. So to buy two, you get one free. I actually, you can see some of the Godzilla ones right there that I already opened up there. I'm literally right here, those two. I got the exclusive twice, which is really cool. I'm going to sell them on Mercari. But I'm going to open up these blind bags with you guys. These are the Godzilla blind bags. I'm really only buying this particular collection because I want that Space Godzilla. And I felt around this one was really thick. What are the chances? I literally just opened it up and the one main piece I wanted is in here. The only reason why I was buying these is for this exact one. One down. Let's see what we got here. Again, we want, I mean, I'll take the Biollant too, but we really want the Anglis. So, sealed pack. No, it's not it. And we got a Godzilla. Actually, I got doubles of this one, so that's cool. So anyway, I got a kick out of these, but it was buy because I was a pro member, I buy two, I get one free. So I ended up getting the exclusive again, and I got the one I wanted, so I don't need to buy any more of them. We got actually a Godzilla one. Hey, listen, if you comment below, I'll send you this one. I'll send it to you. It's all yours. I'll send it to you. Or maybe I'll send you two. I don't know. I'll surprise you. So yeah, like that's so freaking cool. Let's go. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you guys learned a little bit about what I do because I like to show you guys that so you guys can understand where I'm coming from. So if you are getting into a hobby, just check out what I did there. Rewind it. Understand what I did. I bought one thing for $50, got two, three things at $46 each. That's technically already a $100 profit. But if I sell the other thing for a little bit more, it could be a $120 profit. It doesn't matter because I break even after $50. Either way, I break even. So it's a really cool thing to do, and that's why I like to dabble like that. But I also hope you guys like some of these mystery boxes because we got lucky this week. We got one dud. One dud. They didn't really understand what I was doing, I guess. But they were cool pieces. I just don't really like them. And then, of course, I got a really cool purchase, which was my 1200 Godzilla. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. I look forward to seeing you guys on the next one. Don't forget, like, subscribe, comment below. We'll see you on the next one. It's your boy, Dale Castell, and this is Castell Collects.